Yesterday we were discussing retarded potentials and few of you were not there, so I will just give you a very quick introduction to what we started yesterday. Retarded potentials are nothing but like acceleration and retardation, but here we talk about how electromagnetic waves radiate themselves. Okay, we have studied that electromagnetic waves have they travel in dielectric medium, linear dielectric medium, conductors and vacuum, all these cases we have studied, and we have also seen that accelerated charge will generate EM field. So I can say that it is some arrangement of charge in space that generates, or that is the source of electromagnetic field, right? And electromagnetic field is very important for the propagation of EM waves, whether it is a plane wave or it is a spherical wave or a cylindrical wave, it doesn't matter, but there should be a charge which should be accelerated. But we did not study that how these charge will radiate themselves. That is, if suppose I am at some reference point here, say this is the reference point O, and my charge Q is enclosed in a small volume d tau. This is a small volume d tau, and I say that charge density is rho, and I am interested in finding the electric field and magnetic field at some point P. Okay, and I say that this distance is r dash, and this distance is r. Then this distance is, I denote it by other r. Then this is r minus r dash. Okay, this is the reference point. Now, question is that what will be the electric and magnetic field at point P, okay, when viewed from O? Because of the charge sitting at some point here at a distance r dash from the reference point O, what will be the electric and magnetic field here? Now this is not an electrostatic case. This is a case where charge is moving, charge is accelerated, and we have calculated that E in this case is equal to minus of gradient V minus del A by del T. Okay, so this term here takes care of the time variation in the charge. Okay, and this A, because B is always divergence less, so it allows us to represent B in terms of a vector potential del cross A. And in Lorentz gauge, we had seen that del dot A is equal to minus 1 by C del V by del T. I'm right, it is minus 1 by C square or minus 1 by C, I don't know. It is minus 1 by C square. Okay. And the other two inhomogeneous wave equations are del 2 Laplacian of V minus 1 by C square del 2 V by del T square is equal to minus rho upon epsilon naught. And similarly for A, I have minus 1 by C square del 2 A by del T square is equal to minus mu naught J, where rho is the charge density and J is the current density. Okay. If everything was static, if charge was not moving, it was here, then this term would have gone to 0. Okay. Similarly, here in this equation, this term would have been 0. Okay. And we would have had a very simple equation, del square V is equal to minus rho upon epsilon naught, and del square A is equal to minus mu naught J, giving a solution which we all are familiar with. I can say that V at point R is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integral rho at point R dash upon R d tau. Okay, and tau d tau is the small elementary volume, and similarly I can write that this vector potential A r is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi integral rho j r dash upon r d tau. So this we know, and this we have written from what we know from Coulomb's law. Okay, nothing new has been written here. Now my waves will start from this point. This case is for the static case. If it is not static, if things are changing with time, then I would say that the waves would start from this point and they will reach this point. Okay, they will start from here and they will reach this point. So there will be some time gap. The cause is at this point. The cause is the reason. The reason of field, the root cause of the field that is being produced or that is being observed here is here. So it means fields have to start from here and they have to reach P. So there will be some time gap, okay? And I say that these waves reach this point P at time t, okay? But they started from this cause point at some retarded or some earlier time t r, okay? And if I assume that accelerated charge will produce electromagnetic waves, if I assume that the accelerated charge will produce electromagnetic waves and the space surrounding this small volume is vacuum or air, then these electromagnetic waves should travel with speed of light. Okay? In that case, I can say that T should be equal to, or I can say that T r should be equal to T minus r upon c. Okay, this distance is r. Okay, so it means the waves would have started r by c time earlier than what we are seeing here. Is it clear? So it means now I have a time T r. Now everything, my potential, scalar potential V and vector potential A is changing with time. Okay, I am interested in knowing this potential at time t, okay, which is actually the projection of the potential at point r dash at time t r. Right? Is it clear? I am interested in knowing the potential at point r at some later time t, which is actually the effect of the cause which prevailed at this point, okay, which is at a distance r dash from some reference point O at time t r. Is it clear? Is it clear? Anamika, it's not clear. See, I am interested in finding the potential at point P, which is at a distance r from this small charge density rho, okay. So now earlier we had written a solution which was not varying in time. The solutions were actually solutions of these two equations. But now I say that my charge is varying with time. I am taking an electrodynamic case. I am not anymore interested in electrostatic case, because I know that static charges will not produce EM waves, and I am interested in the radiation of electromagnetic waves. So if this charge is moving, or if this charge is producing electromagnetic wave, if this charge is producing electromagnetic wave, and those waves which start from this small volume will reach P at say time t. And if these waves, I am assuming here that these waves are electromagnetic waves moving with speed c, then it means that if this at point P waves reach at time t, okay, then they should have had started from this point at t minus r upon c, and I call that time as t r, some earlier time or retarded time t r. So this is my retarded time. Okay, so now here I have, so it means potential at point r at time t, potential at point r, at point some point r, okay, at time t is actually the effect of the charge density which was prevailing at point r dash at some earlier time or retarded time t r. Is it clear now? So here we have the cause and the effect. Because of the cause there is an effect. Similarly, I can write here also, this is r t and j r dash t r. Okay. So these are the solutions, things are very simple. Okay. But can I now write, can I directly say that electric field, I know that at this point I know the potential, I know the vector potential, then using these equations, can I directly say that E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught rho r dash t r upon r square into r cap d tau, and B is del cross A. So I can write that mu naught upon 4 pi integral j r dash t r cross r cap upon r square d tau. Can I do this? Can I write this? No, I cannot write. This equation definitely is not right. This equation is definitely not correct. Okay, because I know that I have this term as well. Okay, so it means now in electrostatic case, if we knew the potential, we could straightforward write the electric field by taking the gradient of the potential. But in electrodynamic case, if I know the potential, I cannot calculate electric field straightforward. Okay, so it means I will have to calculate the electric field. And if I say that the equations that I wrote here, these two equations are right, at least these equations for both potentials are correct, okay, then this should satisfy this equation here. Okay, what I mean to say here is, if I take the Laplacian of this equation, if I calculate the Laplacian of this equation, then I must land up at this equation. Okay. And this must result in this inhomogeneous wave propagation equation. These two equations are inhomogeneous equation because they have four variables. Okay. We have an extra time variable. So we will try to do that. So here this is not equal to this and this is not equal to this, just because the charge and current are varying with time. So I cannot write from here that B is this, and from here I cannot write that E is electric field at point r is this. Okay. So it means we need to calculate E and B, because without knowing E and B we cannot tell anything about the radiation at a point. So now we start with that. So we will first start with the potential. So I need to calculate first, we will see here, I need to calculate del square V, which is the divergence of gradient of V, which is equivalent to divergence of gradient of V. So it means first I will take the gradient of this equation and then I will take the divergence of that equation. Okay, this actually we did yesterday, but we will do it again. So I have V r t is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integral, and then I have 1 upon r gradient of rho r dash t r, and plus rho gradient of 1 upon r d tau. Is it okay? Ye theek hai? Now you see, this gradient of rho, that is I am trying to differentiate this with respect to r. Okay, so I can write that gradient of rho is equal to say del rho by del r, and this I can write is del rho by del r and del r by del t r. This is del r. Now you see here, this is rho dot, this is the differentiation of charge with respect to time. So I can say that this is rho dot, and this here is gradient of PR. Okay, and gradient of TR can be calculated from here. Gradient of TR can be calculated from here, and that will be minus 1 by CR cap. Isn't it? From here, T is now constant, will be treated as constant. Okay, so gradient of TR will be equal to minus 1 by CR cap. Del r over del r will be a unit vector. Okay, so here I can write that this is equal to rho dot minus rho dot divided by c into r cap. Okay, and del dot, and here I have gradient of 1 by r. Gradient of 1 by r is minus 1 by r square r cap. Okay, gradient of 1 by r, you have to differentiate with respect to r, 1 by r, so that is equal to, so I can write here gradient of 1 by r is equal to minus r cap upon r square, right. So I substitute these values there, I substitute these values here, and what I get is, so I get that gradient of v, I am leaving all these, you know, position and time coordinate, I have 1 minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and then I have minus 1 by c rho dot upon r into r cap plus rho upon r square r cap d tau. ठीक है ये. Now you take the divergence of this equation. Take the divergence of this equation. So when you take the divergence, this becomes del square v, this becomes del square v, and when I take the divergence, I have minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integral. Now I have two functions, I have here two terms, and each of them are function, there is a scalar field and a vector field. Bataiye, Vatika. पूछिए पूछिए क्वेश्चन. यहाँ पे यहाँ नहीं आएगा, जब आप इसे सॉल्व कर लेंगे तब माइनस साइन आएगा, नहीं यहाँ नहीं आएगा माइनस. ओके, माइनस साइन विल कम व्हेन वी विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दीज वैल्यूज ओवर देयर. यू आर टेकिंग अ डायरेक्ट ग्रेडियंट, राइट. सो I have here, now I have to take the divergence of this whole equation. So you see here, I will just take this case, I will leave 1 by c. So you have two function rho dot and r cap upon r. These So you have to take the divergence of these two. Rho is scalar. Rho is a scalar field. Rho is a scalar field, and 1 by r is a vector quantity. Okay. So it means I can write that I will write the general formula here that rho dot t v, where v is vector, is equal to gradient of t dot v plus t into del dot v. This is the formula. So I will substitute this here. So I will have 1 by c gradient of rho dot in dot r cap upon r plus 1 by c rho dot del dot r cap upon r plus, now I will go come to the second term. Second term would be gradient of rho dot r cap upon r square plus rho r cap upon r square d tau. Okay. Now I have few new terms. I have gradient of rho dot. Okay. I have gradient of rho dot, and also I have rho dot and gradient of rho. So, okay. First, what I will do is I will open this. So, when I open this, you can see here for gradient of rho, I can put that value minus rho dot upon c into r cap. So I will substitute that value here there. So I will have 1 by c rho dot into r cap upon r. Right? Okay. Now del dot r cap upon r is minus 1 by r square. This term is minus 1 by r square, isn't it? Minus 1 by r square. So I have here, so I can write for this term, I can write that this is equal to minus 1 by r square into r cap. Okay. Here there should have been r square. Yeah. Yahan pe r square hai. This is going r square, right? This will be 1 by r square. देखिए second term में 1 by r square है. अब देखिए यदि मैं इस sign को अंदर multiply कर दूँ तो ये दो term cancel हो जाएंगे. ये दो term cancel हो जाएंगे, isn't it? So I am left with, you can see here, this term and this term will cancel out. This term and this term will cancel out, and I will have minus, or I will write it like this, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integral minus 1 by c gradient of rho dot into r cap upon r, and then I will have that term. So that is minus rho del dot r cap upon r square d tau. बताइए. हाँ, एक्चुअली ये जो नेगेटिव साइन है वो केवल इसके साथ ही चलेगा शायद, नहीं नहीं सबके साथ चलेगा। दे शुड हैव हैड कैंसल्ड, एक बार से चेक करिए, दे शुड हैव हैड कैंसल्ड। एक बार इसको कैलकुलेट करके देखिए, इट शुड हैव हैड कैंसल्ड। आई विल चेक वन मिनट। हाँ वो पॉजिटिव है, दिस वन इज पॉजिटिव। ओके एक बार दोबारा कर लेते हैं, कोई बात नहीं, एक बार दोबारा कर लेते हैं, कंफ्यूजन है तो ये दोबारा कर लेते हैं। इसको दोबारा कर, सो आई एम टेकिंग डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ दिस, सो डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ दिस इज माइनस वन बाय सी ग्रेडियंट ऑफ रो डॉट इन टू आर कैप अपॉन आर माइनस रो डॉट इन टू डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ आर कैप अपॉन आर एंड आई एम टेकिंग दिस टर्म ऑल्सो टूगेदर and this term is again the negative sign will come here, so I have minus gradient of rho dot r upon r cap upon r square minus rho into divergence of r cap upon r square d term, is it okay? ये ठीक है, नेगेटिव साइन हम लेके चल रहे हैं, सेकंड में वन बाय सी आएगा, ठीक है। सो अब देखिए वन अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट, दिस इज माइनस वन बाय सी ग्रेडियंट ऑफ रो डॉट इनटू डॉट प्रोडक्ट विद आर। ओके नाउ हियर आई हैव रो डॉट, सो रो डॉट इज इक्वल टू, rho dot is equal to minus this is equal to plus rho dot and this is equal to 1 by r square, so this will become plus, so I will have rho dot by r c into 1 by r square into r cap, is it okay? ठीक है, ये डेल डॉट आर अपॉन आर इज माइनस वन बाय आर स्क्वायर आर कैप अपॉन आर स्क्वायर। नाउ आई कम हियर एंड दिस इज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ रो, दिस इज इक्वल टू रो डॉट अपॉन सी डॉट r cap upon r square, sorry here I will write r cap and here I have rho, यहाँ पे नहीं आएगा, अब इसको ऐसे रख लीजिए, रो डेल डॉट आर कैप अपॉन आर स्क्वायर डी टाउ। सो नाउ यू कैन, कहाँ पे आर कैप नहीं आएगा, यहाँ पे नहीं आएगा, अभी डॉट प्रोडक्ट लिया कहाँ है, कौन से इस वाले टर्म से, अच्छा यहाँ पे नहीं आएंगे, ठीक कह रहे। नाउ आई कैन राइट दैट दिस इज इक्वल टू 1/4 pi epsilon naught इंटीग्रल माइनस 1/c ग्रेडियंट ऑफ रो डॉट डॉट प्रोडक्ट आर कैप अपॉन आर माइनस रो डेल डॉट आर कैप अपॉन आर स्क्वेयर डी टाउ। नाउ क्वेश्चन इज आई कैन कैलकुलेट दिस बट वॉट इज दिस, कैन यू गिव मी द वैल्यू ऑफ डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ आर कैप अपॉन आर स्क्वेयर। क्या आप ये कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं इन स्फेरिकल पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट्स? बताइए। डेल डॉट आर कैप अपॉन आर स्क्वेयर, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू? चलिए इसको कैलकुलेट करिए। ये बताइए डेल डॉट आर कैप अपॉन आर स्क्वायर की वैल्यू क्या होगी? बताइए, कैन यू कैलकुलेट? इफ आई सी दिस इज व्हाट 1/r² इज व्हाट, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड। आई हैव अ प्लस क्यू चार्ज एंड फील्ड्स आर रेडिएटिंग आउटवर्ड्स। ओके, फील्ड्स आर रेडिएटिंग आउटवर्ड्स एंड 1/r² इज एक्चुअली द शोइंग द पॉजिटिव डाइवर्जेंस। ओके, दिस फंक्शन इज शोइंग द पॉजिटिव डाइवर्जेंस। दिस फंक्शन इज बिकॉज इफ सपोज आई हैव वी, आई हैव वी, v in absolute term is you know rho upon 4 pi epsilon naught r, 4 pi epsilon naught r. So only this term, see everything is constant, only 1/r is showing, or if I say this is electric field, then 1/r² term is showing me, giving me the divergence. Okay, so it means 1/r² is the example of very large divergence. I know if I have 1/r² and there is a positive charge, it means there is a positive divergence. And now you can see here, this has got a spherical symmetry. Here it has got a spherical symmetry. So if I try to take the divergence, all theta phi terms are zero. If I try to take the divergence for the first term would be, that is for the r term would be 1/r² del over del r into r² and the function, and the function, whatever is the function, if I say that it is del dot v, then the divergence for the first term is 1/r² del over del r² v. This is the first term. Okay, so I have here 1/r². Okay, and when I write that this is 1/r², then I can write that this is equal to 1/r² del over del r of 1, isn't it? So what I say, that this function has got zero divergence. If I say that this function has zero divergence, it means that there is no divergence, that is, it means that there is no electric field coming out of a positive charge. There is no electric field terminating at a negative charge. So it means this calculation that we did is wrong. This calculation that we did here is wrong, isn't it? So it means if I look at the same calculation slightly in a different way, see what here we are getting, that del dot v is equal to 0. But I am very sure that del dot 1/r² is not 0. So if I apply the Gauss theorem, then I can write that del dot v d tau over volume integral is equal to v dot dA over a closed surface. यही होगा, दिस इज इक्वल टू दिस. सो इफ आई कैलकुलेट द सर्फेस इंटीग्रल ऑफ 1 बाई आर स्क्वेयर, इफ आई ट्राई टू कैलकुलेट द सर्फेस इंटीग्रल ऑफ 1 बाई आर स्क्वेयर, देन आई विल हैव इंटीग्रल 1 बाय से आई एम कैलकुलेटिंग दिस वैल्यू एट आर इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल आर, अ स्फेयर ऑफ रेडियस आर, देन आई विल हैव 1 बाय आर स्क्वेयर. आर स्क्वेयर किसी स्फेयर का स्फेरिकल पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट में एरिया क्या होता है? आर स्क्वेयर साइन थीटा डी थीटा डी फाई इंटू आर कैप. ठीक है, सो दिस आई हैव डबल इंटीग्रल, वन इज ओवर थीटा एंड अदर वन इज ओवर फाई. सो आर एंड आर इज गेटिंग कैंसल्ड, आर एंड आर इज गेटिंग कैंसल्ड. सो नाउ आई हैव दिस इंटीग्रल गोइंग फ्रॉम 0 टू पाई फॉर थीटा एंड 0 टू 2 पाई फॉर फाई. ओके, एंड व्हेन यू कैलकुलेट दिस द वैल्यू इज, ये साइन थीटा विल बी माइनस कॉस थीटा एंड हियर आई हैव ओनली डी फाई, सो इट विल बी 4 पाई, द वैल्यू विल बी 4 पाई. ओके, सो इट मीन्स डेल डॉट आर बाय आर स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू 4 पाई एंड अ डेल्टा फंक्शन आर. सो व्हाट आई डेल्टा क्यूब आर, दिस वैल्यू इज 1, दिस इज अ डेल्टा फंक्शन. ओके, सो एट आर इज इक्वल टू 0, दैट इज एट द ओरिजिन, एट द ओरिजिन वेयर वी हैव द चार्ज सिटिंग, इफ दिस पॉइंट वी कंसिडर एज द ओरिजिन, देन देयर वी विल हैव मैक्सिमम डाइवर्जेंस. इट मीन्स दैट सो ऑलवेज डेल डॉट आर बाय आर स्क्वेयर इज 4 पाई डेल्टा क्यूब आर, वेयर डेल्टा इज द डिराक डेल्टा फंक्शन, इट इज अ डेल्टा फंक्शन. ओके, कमिंग फ्रॉम when you are trying to calculate coming from there. Okay, so you are trying to differentiate a delta function. This derivation is important, this comes like a problem in sometimes in exam, so you please note it down. So now I move here, now I come here, where did I write the last term? Okay, last. So the last term is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus 1 by c del rho dot r cap upon r minus this. So now I can write that in place of this I replace that value and I have 4 pi delta cube r. Now what about this del rho dot? See, rho dot is equal to gradient of rho is rho dot by c into r cap. Okay, and so gradient of rho dot should be equal to rho double dot by c into r cap. लिख सकते हैं, बताइए. Integral 0 to pi sin theta d theta integral 0 to 2 pi d phi. This is the azimuthal angle. If I have like this, then this will rotate like this, phi angle. This is the phi angle, this will rotate like this, and this is your theta angle which will rotate like this. This is the polar angle and this is the azimuthal angle. Phi goes from 0 to 2 pi, azimuthal angle, and polar angle goes from 0 to pi. So now you can see this is 0 to pi, this is minus cos theta minus 1. Okay, so this becomes 2 and here I have 2 pi, so that becomes 4 pi. Okay, is it clear? So I will remove this. So now I can in this place, in place of del rho dot, in place of del rho dot, I can write this is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by c square into rho double dot by r rho double dot by r minus rho 4 pi delta cube r into d tau. Okay, this is rho double dot here, or it is del rho by del 2 rho by del t square. Now, if I again look at this equation, here I have del square v. Here I have del square v. Okay, so if I look at this part, only at this part, I will have. You can write, see, 1 by c square is constant. Okay, if I am differentiating with respect to time, r is also a constant. R is also a constant. Okay, so I can write the first term as. I will write down here. So this first term, I am coming from here to here. So I can write that this is equal to del square v is equal to 1 by c square del 2 by del t square 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integral rho by r d tau. First term, can I write like this? Because this and this are constant, only rho charge density is changing with time. Okay, and what is this inside this integral? It is v, it is v. Okay, and when I come here, when I multiply this 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught here, then I am left with rho upon epsilon naught del cube r d tau. Okay, so I am here left with minus rho upon epsilon naught. If I assume that del cube rho is a small unit volume, if you see the first diagram, we had drawn a small cube. Okay, so if that is the volume of that cube, then when integrated over the whole stuff, then I have rho upon epsilon naught. Okay, so this is v. So I get an equation. Here I get del square v is equal to 1 by c square del 2 v by del t square minus rho upon epsilon naught. Or I can write this is equal to del square v minus 1 by c square del square v by del t square is equal to minus rho upon epsilon naught. You check this, this is the inhomogeneous wave equation. You can check. This is what we wrote earlier, isn't it? So it means the assumption that we made, assumptions, certain assumptions we made, that you know that our waves are traveling with speed c is correct. And another thing we again prove, that Lorentz gauge del dot a is equal to minus 1 by c del v by del t is also correct. Because in Lorentz gauge, the value of del dot a was arbitrarily chosen by us. We chose that value. So it means all that we chose arbitrarily is correct, because when I take v and I find the Laplacian, I end up at the inhomogeneous wave equation. Okay. So now your, for you, the assignment is you must do the same for a. You do the same for a and end up at the same inhomogeneous wave equation for a. Okay. So this finishes your fourth unit.